And that is a big disadvantage for Alliance.
Yeah, both mid laners also picking up the heal. Oh, Tab's going straight in there. He's going to get caught out with the Zenith Blade. Quickly locked up. Exhaust was used, but he does flash out of it. The way we can see that Jankos is going to move on through, and this is going to be surely obvious to Rockat. Shook waiting in there. The pillar goes down. Zaza's hit by the Q. The exhaust is on him as well. It's going to be good damage, but will it be enough damage? Shook actually falling quite low as well. He has to safeguard away. No kill coming out there in the top lane.
Proving that at least still can put it down. Nip getting caught out in this bottom lane. He's taking a lot of damage this time around. Has still got that flash exhaust available, and Tabs was trying to lay down some damage of his own. You can see he was moving, ready to cocoon that try, but straight away instead they're going to jump on towards Tabs. Tabs takes the tower here, I think, there. Vander taking a lot of damage. Vander continuing his aggression here. Very deep.
Got plenty of disengage in there as well. Thinking of that, we've got Shook now headed up towards his top side. Exhaust goes down onto Zazas, and look at Zazas, he's moving off to that bottom side. Shook here will be relying on the Q, which does land, but already in the tri-bush. No vision of Elise. Not worth it there for Shook to follow through.
In the top lane, he's still very close, though. He will be able to join in.
Good spear from Frog and lands, takes half the hit points off Celebrate. As you mentioned, Shook already here. Overpower goes aggressive. Shook quickly in there to respond, but Frog is going to get taken down. That's the first blood. Cocoon on Nip. Nip in trouble. He gets pounced on. Another bouncing bomb will turn the story. And that is Celebrate that picks it up with a couple of shots from Lucian.
Easy take for them. Zazas here going to try and stop Wicked from being such an annoyance here. Actually, Wicked going to pop his ultimate. Going to try and put some damage back on towards Zazas. Zazas using his subjugate there will steal all that health back. At least sneak into that top side. Actually, will be spotted here as Wicked dashes forward. And there, I don't think there's going to be a kill from this. Or maybe there will. The cocoon is going to land on towards Shook. It will kick Zazas straight through. Jankos getting knocked up as well.
They're all on his own, going aggressive. Zazas in trouble this time. Shook is going to come in. They will get the kill. That's what they needed. Jankos does a lot of damage back down on towards it. Got around the back of Wicked at the moment. Overpower's now going to be the focus. Shook's coming in towards him. Can that spear land? Yes, it will. That may well signal the attack. Wicked, meanwhile, in trouble in the top lane. He's using that dominance to try and get away, and he will get taken down by Jankos. And Overpower in the mid lane did escape from Shook and Froggen.
Longer laning phase because Zazas gets to the point where he can duel them. They're going in.
They're going to dive in there. The Cullings comes out. There's the solar flare as well. Shook going to safeguard away. A good kick, but he doesn't knock the entire team up. Now they dive towards Nip, and here comes Zazas from the side. Shook is very, very low. It's going to be Tab Shuler. They focus. No flashing from Zazas. He can tank that turret all day long. It's a whitewash for Rockat. Three kills and a turret.
They're going to go four members onto this one. Zazas caught out a little bit by Wicked. Wicked putting pressure down. Frog is going to join the fray as well. He's going to come pouncing towards him. Remember, he can throw out those big spears. There's the exhaust going down. They're going to go into the tower. The Zazas is going down there. Now the rest of Rockat, they're coming around the backside. Shook and Nip are actually low on health. This is a risky siege, and they are going to back off.
Fight gave up a kill, and also the Dragonfall Alliance.
Oh, Overpower going to throw his ultimate out here. That's half of Shook's HP gone. Are they going to keep chasing? Yes, they are. Vander coming around the side. He's got the solar flare available. There's two men stuck up right there for him. We see Celebrate coming in the side. They've managed to catch Nip. Zenith Blade lands as well. That's a kill now for Celebrate as he moves on to a killing spree. Going to go in there for Shook.
Alliance taking his dragon very low. Teleport coming in from Zazas. He wants to join this one. It is going to be a steal. Jankos got in there to get it, but what cost though? That's the problem. There's going to be the Cullen coming out. Not really catching. Solar flare. That does. Wicked's going to be the focus target. He's not as strong as he needs to be. There's a lot of damage going on towards him. Shook in trouble. One more shot. One more bomb. Rattling through. No. Celebrate taking low. They turn it back around. Frog is trying to land the spears. Trying to get a pick. He will come through. It's only hit Zazas, so the tankiest member. And Rockat disengaged. While this is all happening, Wicked is pushing the mid lane turret wave. He has turned array. Overpower now caught down alone. Can one more shot come out? It will do. Overpower's going to pay the price. He's going to go down. The middle turret will be picked up. You can see Wicked taking that one down. It's a dragon to Rockat, but it's going to be a tower and a kill for Alliance.
Yeah.
Going to do a lot of damage, I would say. If all the help, there is one of the picks they needed to make. It's Nip getting caught out. Tries to speed himself up. Hasn't got enough to get away with this one. Tabs putting damage down. He avoids the solar flare. Celebrate taking low. Necrophana bomb comes in. Tabs is low. He gets taken down by Celebrate. Shook's going to be the next focus target. There's going to be the pillar of ice. Forces him onto the tower.
Which is what it is maybe like up there, but not particularly in the game. Jankos actually getting caught out here. Let's see how strong he actually is. He's going to get kicked. No, he's not. He repels just at the right time. Shook can't get the damage onto him. There's a cocoon turn around, and Shook all of a sudden finds himself
up. Oh,
the Cullen comes through. It's Jankos that gets the kill.
Without any problems. Froggen in trouble here. Zazas actually laying down a lot of damage. Pillar of Ice, though, will just pounce away from it and actually blocks Zazas in his tracks. Oh, they're going in on towards this one. Celebar was the focus target. Wicked not strong enough to go up against four members of Rocket, that's for sure. Mega Inferno Bomb slung out, does not land. Yes, it does. It actually took down Nif, completely nailed him there where he stood.
Been pushing down onto that final inhib, and they were just waiting for those minions to actually come around the side from this one. They're going to start focusing those Nexus turrets as Panda goes diving in onto them. They don't get the kills there, but they've got rid of the Nexus turrets. The Nexus itself will fall down, and it will be Rocket that pick up game number one.